This is Byron Harrison, then Pri Rochdale away. Byron, great win on Monday, and your partnership with Jamie Cureton sort of bearing fruit again.
Yeah, it was nice to obviously carry on the good away form, and I thought we were getting stronger as the game went on, and it was nice to see, you know, Kiro get a couple of goals, and the teams keep clean sheet and win. You know, it's important.
Our commentator said you were bullying the Mansfield centre-halves, which sounds a bit unfair, but it's also it's a big compliment as well, isn't it?
Yeah, better to be, you know, bullying than bullied. So, no, at that stage I was just enjoying the game. You know, we're taking every game seriously towards it, you know, to the very end, so, you know, we wanted the points.
And I suppose looking forward to the next two games, that's key because, you know, you can still finish in the top half of the table, can't you?
Yeah, that's important. We want to finish as high as possible. I'm sure the manager wants that as well. So, you know, that's the aim. So every game, you know, we'll be looking to put in the performances all season. Don't get me wrong, but you know, we'll fight until the end.
And obviously, you know, no one's questioning the effort all season, but obviously the results haven't been there. Can you put your finger on why? Because there's so many enigmas, aren't there?
Yeah, I wish I could. It has been a very difficult season. I mean, a lot of our best games have been away, and I suppose for the fans, you know, who don't travel, they've only seen our home form. So it's been really difficult. I can't put my finger on what's actually gone wrong. We have made a lot of mistakes, and even to cut out, you know, half of those mistakes would have had us a lot safer, maybe a lot closer to playoffs actually, with something to play for.
Is there something that, I suppose, teams are expected to take more risks at home, they're expected to be more on the front foot, whereas away from home maybe, you know, you'll be a little bit more conservative in your approach as a side?
Yeah, that's normally what happens, but also, you know, I'm not really sure if that's what's happening with us, because we've actually taken the lead in so many games at home, and we've been in the lead not just one, like 1-0, but we've been in the lead like a 2-0 or 2-1 and still not taking the points there. So it's kind of hard to put your finger on what actually leads to that. Or I don't know. I don't think it's a case of us not having the right approach to home games, because we take the lead. So something's right, but then also something goes massively wrong, especially when we concede.
Going back to your partnership with Jamie, obviously, you know, that, as I said, bearing fruit at the moment. Just how long has that sort of taken you to feel, you know, to get the understanding that you have? Because obviously now it's looking really good.
I don't know. I feel like we've had little runs in the team where it has not set the world alight, but you know, there's been little indications there that that can work, and the little and large thing generally works anyway. You know, Jamie's strengths are stretching the game, you know, feeding off of it, off anything that you know, comes off the target man, which is myself. So, you know, I can't speak highly enough of someone like Jamie Cureton. You know, I've learned a lot from him this season. You know, he's been a pleasure to play alongside, and the understanding is there, because he's a man who's played, I don't want to quote how many games he's actually played, but you know, he's played hundreds of games. So, you know, the intelligence is there, and I feel like I'm getting better and better, you know, as I learn and get my appearances up as well. So I think that can only, you know, do the team well from now to the end of the season, and hopefully next season if both around.
And obviously you're here next season, you've got a contract, presumably you'd be delighted if he gets one as well.
Of course, like, you know, he's done his chances, he's put that in the manager's head now, you know. It's starting to come good, the partnership. You know, the manager stuck with it for a few games, which you know, I played up front with a few different people, and obviously he's played up front with a few different people. But yeah, it'd be nice if we're both around next year, and we can get that understanding. You know, because it's hard to keep building new understandings of new players sometimes. But you know, that's not my decision. I'll come back and play for Cheltenham up front with whoever is here. But I'd love that to be Jamie.
And obviously people make a lot about his age, but I suppose the thing is, he's making the right runs rather than some younger players who might make, you know, some of the wrong runs, so it's easier for you to find him.
Yeah, literally, the intelligence of like I said, I can't speak highly enough of him. The intelligence of his runs, you know, have led him to you know, have the chances he has. Like no one else that I played up front with this season, and they have all have different strengths. So I'm not saying it's better or worse, but the type of runs he makes, they're only the runs of someone with his experience would make. You know, someone who's played where he's played, and obviously has over 250 league goals to his name. So yeah,
it's impressive stuff, isn't it? Talked about the away form being good, and obviously looking to continue that this week. At Rochdale, tough looking place to go.
Yeah, it'll be all competitive because we know that they could still go up automatically. So from that point of view, you know, our mindset away is the same. You know, we go and we try our best to get the 3 points. We know that they're not going to take it lightly, and we definitely won't be either.
And in terms of what happened first half against Fleetwood, you know, you've shown how you can mix it with the sides who are up there chasing automatic, haven't you?
Yeah, we've done that, I think, on more than one occasion this season with the teams that are up there. And even for long spells when we played Rochdale at Auden Road, I think we was on top for a little bit of that game. I know they came through strong at the end, but you know we was in the lead that game. We got to take. We know they're going to play, so we have to work hard to stop that at source, and then impose ourselves on from maybe a counter-attacking angle.
How much do you enjoy the challenge of this time of the season, going to somewhere like Rochdale where there's going to be a big crowd, people are going to be excited about the possibilities, and obviously it's a little bit of a bigger stage for you guys to play on as well, isn't it?
Yeah, you've got to enjoy every game of football. You know, I've learned that more than probably anyone this year, you know, to learn to enjoy my football a bit more. And you know, like I said, we can't go up, we can't go down, you know, the pressure will be on them, so we should just go out there and enjoy it, work hard. That's the basis of any good performance, but express ourselves like we started to do towards the end of the Mansfield game.
And has that been the key for you this season, because obviously this season's been fantastic for you?
Yeah, I mean, I've said all season the main thing for me would be to get the appearances were important to me. Obviously the goals are important to me, but it's how much I make it out on the pitch. And if I make it out on the pitch often enough, I know that I'm doing something right. So, you know, and I'll just learn from the season and come back, hopefully, a stronger player.
Good man, thank you. Good luck.
Cheers.
Byron, do you think Jamie has improved you as a player? Because he's spoken quite often this season about how he's got in your ear. And has he been annoying almost to the point of pushing you on?
Not annoying. Not someone with that knowledge of the game. You know, I respect him enough to not say like it's annoying. But yeah, he has been speaking to me the whole season, and I do feel like I have improved. You know, I think for a long time, I think as a professional, I didn't want to see myself as like a target man. Like I didn't want to see myself as, oh yeah, I didn't know what that would quite represented as a player. I wanted to go like be on the turf, like, you know, face defenders up and stuff. But you know, speaking to Jay, you know, he's allowed me to embrace it more, and I feel like it's a role that I actually want to excel at now. It's a role that I'm learning, because like I said, I didn't really want to consider myself a stand-up target man, but no, I'd be lying if I said I haven't improved under, you know, a little bit of his guidance, and just through playing the games as well.
Yeah, even though you're disappointed with the way the season's gone overall, do you think it's been your best season in the Football League as a player?
For sure. I still wanted more goals, but yeah, I see it as, you know, the first stepping stone and where I want to go to, you know. I can only see it getting better. You know, this season will do me a world of good.
Yeah, and there probably aren't that many target men who would still be players if they weren't 6'3". But is that what you mean by not wanting to sort of...
Yeah, in my head, I kind of just see myself as I can do a bit on the floor sometimes. You know, a lot of the game I spend with my back to goal, and it can be frustrating because sometimes I don't get enough shots on goal as I would have liked or whatever. But that's, I think I'm starting to come around to the fact that that's the role in itself. You know, it is, you know, maybe the person next that plays alongside you who's facing in on goal more often is supposed to be the guy who nicks more goals, but you know, you still have a big role to play. You know, it's not all about just chasing the glory of the goals. It's like it's a little bit more selfless.
Yeah,
I'm coming to terms now.
Yeah,
I like that now.
On Monday, you got the ball smashed in your face. A couple of minutes later, you were running at the defence and setting up the first goal for Jamie. So that, did that annoy you? did that make you want to set up a goal?
No, I mean, that hurt. But no, I tried to just shake that off. I mean, their defenders, they gave me a hard time for most of the game, especially first half. We got a lot of balls up in the air, so it was nice to just get it down on the ground. You know, I tried to put them under pressure so I could actually, you know, work that chance to actually get it down. A lot of the time it's up there, and I just want to get it down so much sometimes. It's just, but yeah, it was a good battle. I don't mind like good clean battles with defenders. You know, that's, you know, it's just when you get those defenders that seem to have the aid of the ref and
yeah,
they're fouling you a lot. You know, that's when target man. Those are the harder days.
Yeah, that's brilliant. Cheers, Byron. Yeah, cheers. Thank you.